Hello everybody, this video will be about how to use data from Triaxial test and how to draw more circle and get shear strength parameters for this soil. I took this example from my book, which is called Soil Mechanics Through Project-Based Learning. And you will see that there are three tests, three Triaxial tests. And for each test, we know the confining pressure, sigma 3. That we kept constant, and we know the deviator stress at failure, which changed. So that's set for the first test, second test, and third test. So what we need to get in the end is cohesion and friction angle, if the soil has one. And this is going to be the solution that you can find in the book. I'm going to explain how we arrive at this solution and how we drew these circles and failure envelope as well. So the first thing that we need to do for each test, we need to find principal stresses, sigma 1 and sigma 3. So sigma 3 is given, sigma 3 is confining pressure. So this is already sigma 3. So we need to find sigma 1 for each test. For the first test, sigma 1, it's sigma 3 plus the deviator stress. So it will be sigma 3 is 50 plus 52 will give us 102 kPa. For the second test, we do the same thing. The confining pressure is 100 plus the deviator stress 82. In this case, principal stress, major principal stress will be 182 kPa. And for the third test, we're going to have 200 as confining pressure plus 120 of deviator stress at failure. It will give us 320 kPa. Okay, so this is the first step. Next step is to draw circles. We need to draw axes. So I'll just sketch the axes. Don't forget to label them. This is normal stress. I put it on kPa. This is shear stress, it's in kPa. Make sure that we have same scale, 1 to 1. So in this case, 50, 100. So 50, I'm gonna be 50 here. And 150, 200, 250. Okay. I think you understand how it works. And then we're going to use the first circle from the first test. I will see that the confining pressure is 50. So the first point will be here, 50. This is sigma 3. And sigma 1 is 102 somewhere here. Then we're going to draw a circle. We can use a drawing compass. So this is going to be the radius. We draw a circle. Please use the radius to draw, drawing compass to draw the radius. So next step is we're going to draw a second circle. The confining pressure is 100. So it's here, sigma 3. Sigma 1 is 182. It's somewhere here. So you see the circle will be a little bit greater. And for the third circle, we know that the confining pressure is 200. So this is going to be sigma 3. And the major principal stress at failure will be 320, somewhere here. This is gonna be like a really big circle, like this. So, and the next step is to draw a failure envelope or failure line. So the way we draw is it should be tangent to all three circles as much as possible. Oops, that's a bit wrong. I'm going to erase this one and redraw it. Something like this. Well, when you draw these lines, you need to use rulers. So ideally, it should touch both of the all the circles. Let's say it goes this way. So Well, just look at this example. This is a really good example. And the tangent means that if we draw a line from the center of the circle to the failure envelope line, so this angle is going to be right angle. So it will be 90 degrees. So we should do the same thing here. And I didn't draw a good circle here. So it should touch. So in this case, it should be a straight line like this. This kind of thing you can see in textbook examples where it's perfect, but this example was taken from real practice. So you will see that actually it didn't work well because this failure envelope line is not a tangent, but that's what happens because this is just real life experiment that we conducted in the laboratory, so they're not perfect. So please don't expect all your circles and envelopes be aligned perfectly. And the final step, what we do once we draw the line, which is this failure envelope line, we need to get the angle, which is friction angle. You just measure it. I already measured it's about 10.4 degrees. And here you will see where this failure envelope line crosses shear stress axis. So this is going to be cohesion. And again, we get it from the sketch. In this case, it should be about 13.5 kPa. So that's how it works. Thanks for watching. I hope this video was useful. Have a good day. Bye.